good day. From the Shepherd Center, on the square in St. John, Kansas. It's time now for news for all of Stafford County.
Good afternoon, this is Jim Lakey with news and announcements for St. John, Kansas, and for Stafford County. We're broadcasting on cable channel 9 and on sandylandcenter.org, our website. Today is Friday, the 13th of July. The temperature is 76 at the bank at noontime. We're looking for a high today of 86. It's going to be partly cloudy. Then sunny for Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday, sunny every day. 91 Saturday, 90 Sunday, 92 on both Monday and Tuesday. We're having a good day today for events. Sammy Crispin, happy birthday. Sean and Sal Rosenberg, happy anniversary. Happy birthday tomorrow to LaDonna Garcia, and happy birthday Sunday to Milton John. The County Commissioners meeting will be on Monday, and it'll be after the 6:30 news. The City Council will have a meeting on Tuesday, and it's live, and that meeting will probably be followed by a workshop or a budget session, and that won't be on Channel 9. We have a lot of announcements and events going on. The Farmers Market is Saturdays. It's in front of the Second Chances, which is at Main and Fifth Street, 9 until noon. And if you have questions, you can call Jane Dale at 3664. Then the pool is offering swimming lessons. Candy Teichman is the instructor. And you should sign up at the pool or call the swimming pool during their hours, and they'll take your questions. Then there is a program of bikes for kids, and you can donate bicycles. It's to Xi Zeta Eta, a ladies' sorority in town, and they're collecting these, and they're going to bring them to Larned and have them fixed, at Ellsworth Correctional Institution. They're going to have them fixed, and then they'll distribute them to needy children. These can be at the ASF office at 804 East 1st Street during regular business hours. Well, we're coming to the end of the program for the young people, the kids travel. The next one, after the siren, is Wednesday the 18th. Somebody told me it's Friday the 13th. I should have probably said that, and maybe it's because it is Friday the 13th that we're having fun like this. Salt City Splash is July 18th, next Wednesday, and that is the last of the travel club that we have. Also, the Rec Commission is having movie and a popcorn for 4-year-olds to age 10, and you can call 6549 for information. Those are every Wednesday, and the 18th and the 25th are the next two at 2 o'clock. And they have popcorn, and the library's cool, and a really great movie. Then We have good news. The old Twin Pines restaurant is being reopened and called Dawn Doe Restaurant. And they need waitresses, cooks, and dishwashers. And you can apply at the restaurant. It says at 806 East 1st Street. And I think that's the building of the restaurant. Then the Southern Baptist Church is having its Bible studies, the summer vacation Bible school. And it's called Game Day Central, where heroes are made. So this is going to be at 2nd and Exchange Street, the 22nd through the 26th, which is a Sunday through Thursday, from 6:30 to 8:30 in the evening, and children age 3 through grade 6 are invited. And you can call Rita Clausing at 549-3520 if you have questions. Then finally, I was just given this morning a notice that the St. John Knights of Columbus are sponsoring a fundraiser, a Texas Hold'em tournament, and prime rib dinner at the VFW at St. John, Kansas. That will be 6 o'clock Saturday, July 28th. The grand prize is a trip for two to Las Vegas. Our second prize is $100, third prize is $50. So there's a second chance tournament also to be played. And the proceeds from this event go to a really good local charity. So for ticket information, call Steve Freach at 620-617-8700 or Jared at 620-786-9579. And this concludes all our events. I have found it somewhat humorous as a little bit of a commentary on our nation, that our Congress that hasn't been able to agree on anything this year except naming a few streets and post offices and raising the minimum wage is now criticizing the legislature in Iraq for not having all of their benchmarks met with their government. And I think it's interesting to see who's criticizing who. Anyway, the word of the day would apply to all of this, and that's try to fix the mistake and not fix the blame. This is Jim Lakey, hoping you have a really great Friday and a great weekend.